renal vein, what it will
cleaned
do?
Blood.
Renal vein, it will put urea-free cleaned blood into it. Correct or not? That is what the
yes,
use of this blood capillary. So this blood capillary, after filtration, which has been free, cleaned blood from the glomerulus, this blood capillary, which is surrounded the tubule, which is surrounded the tubule. Why it is surrounded tubule? You may ask me the question now itself. So that we are having a function of it. That is also we'll discuss now. Sir, why can't it directly connected to this? Understanding renal vein. So why it has been surrounding by this tubule means we have a function. Why we have a use of this surrounding, that I will say you it now. So observe very carefully. Opposite side means another side of this glomerulus, we have a one blood capillary which is surrounded by this tubule, and finally it is connected to what? Renal vein.
Renal vein.
So in renal vein, what it will do? This blood capillary, it will
bring the blood.
It will bring the
cleaned blood.
In the sense of what? Free from urea free blood. Urea free blood means no urea content is present. Urea free blood has been putting urea free blood into where? Blood into the renal vein. Understand all of you? Yes or no? Now, here you may understand it. So finally, we can conclude it. Observe very carefully. Sir, where is the proximal tubule in this diagram? You just wait, then I will say. So now observe very carefully here. By this time you may understand who is the filtration unit of kidneys, where the blood is filtered. Where the blood is filtered, yeah? Glomerulus only. Correct or not? So what is the functioning of glomerulus? That is what I am asking. What is the function of glomerulus? Let me see who will say. Function of glomerulus. You may understand now, correct? We have studied. What is the functioning of glomerulus?
Filters blood, sir.
Just filters the blood when it is passing through it. So whenever the blood is passing through it, it will do the filtration. That's all. That is what we should say called as functioning of
glomerulus.
Do you understand all of you? Any doubt in this ask? Okay. So now, here if you observe, this blood which is present inside this dirty blood contains not only this urea, understand, urea, and also this excess water, and as well as some other kind of, what is that called as? Some other salts and all. So it also contains small molecules of substances like glucose, amino acid, some useful salts, and large molecules also it contains like urea and excess water, something, etc. So now, what is the filter? What is the functioning of this? What is the functioning of this one? So this glomerulus, whenever the blood is coming from the dirty blood is coming from the renal artery, you may observe, this blood contains all the things. It is all, not only contains this urea, remember all of you, not only contains this urea and other excess salts and excess water, it also contains so many substances, useful substances for our body. That is what we should call it as what? It also contains glucose. Do you understand it? But why, sir, glucose and all not filtered? Why only urine means? We have a reason. It. Observe very all of you. So what it contains, other substances, it also contains, what is that? Glucose. Amino acids. Amino
acids.
Acids. Next, salts. Salts. Urea. Water. Etc. Etc. So many substances is present in. So, if you observe, whatever the small molecules of substances present in this blood, they will pass us through this. Whenever the blood is passing through this glomerulus, understand? Whenever the blood is passing through this glomerulus, and what will happen means, this glomerulus will collect and filtrate the Bowman capsules, like in the sense of all these useful substances like glucose and amino acids, whatever they are present, small molecules has been absorbed by this Bowman capsule. You may observe here. Next, I will show you the nephron structure. In that structure, you can observe. So whatever the small substances are present inside this blood, everything has been absorbed directly by what? Directly by what? Bowman capsule means in a sense of Bowman capsule. having a porous medium. Do you understand all of you? Bowman capsule is having porous medium, which will allow what? Only small kind of substances. Understand, ra? Small molecules will pass through it, and big molecules and all will never pass through it. That is what I am saying. So the small molecules of substances which is present in the blood, like this glucose and amino acids, etc., salts, they will pass through the glomerulus, and they will be collect as a filtrate. They will collect as a filtrate. Filtrate. What is the meaning of filtrate? Is it good or bad? You have to tell me. Chemistry you have studied, filtration process. So filtration process, I will explain you now here, those who don't know. What is filtrate? Anybody can say? What is filtrate? Chemistry, you go to the chemistry and tell me. So as we know, if I will consider the thermos flask, this is what my thermos flask. Now here I will keep some kind of, understand, and filtration paper, and if I will keep the dirty water here, so slowly drop wise, the clean water will be collected here, and all the salt and the unnecessary sand and everything will be stuck inside this zone. Is it yes or no? Please tell me.
Yes,
this is what we should call as filtration, correct? Is it true or not? Separation, yes, by using a membrane. Understand all of you. So here we are using a filter paper. So when the dirty water will pass through this filter water, all the dirt, sand, etc., etc., will stuck inside this only. Inside this, understand? And only the water will pass through that membrane, and it has been collected at the beaker. That means this beaker. So this is what we should call as the clean water which has been collected here. That is what we should call as filtrate. What we should call all of you?
Filtrate.
Filtrate. So, and whatever the substance will stuck here inside this, understanding, funnel, inside this funnel, in the means in filter paper, that is what we should call as residue. What we should call all of you?
Residue.
You understand? Residue. What is the meaning of residue? Residue means what? Unwanted substances. What we should call?
Unwanted substances.
Let me observe very carefully. Let me see who will explain this one. So here also, Bowman capsule, whenever the blood is passing through this Bowman capsule, the small substances or small molecules like glucose, amino acids, everything has been passed through this Bowman capsule, like filter paper. And they have been collected by a collecting jar. What is that jar called as? Bowman capsules. Understand all of you? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Bowman capsules. So everything, whatever the small molecules of this blood, like glucose, amino acids, salts, urea, etc., etc., everything has been collected, understand, by this Bowman capsule from the glomerulus. Any doubt here? Yes. Now you observe here. So once it has been filtered, remaining blood again will pass through the another side of glomerulus. That blood is called as what? Cleaned blood. What we should call?
Cleaned blood.
So now here you can see, when it is passing through the glomerulus and it will collect as a filtrate, what we should call as? This all small molecules. What is this small molecules called as? Small molecules called as only filtrate, which has been collected.
Filtrate,
which has been collected by Bowman capsule. What we should call?
Bowman
capsule. Sir, small molecules is coming. Then what about large protein molecules? If you take large proteins and even like something big molecules, large molecules we can call as. Large molecules like proteins, etc. Understand? And the blood cells, they cannot pass through these glomerulus and they cannot be collected by this Bowman capsule. All of you should remember. So the big, large molecules like proteins and blood cells cannot passes out through the glomerulus capillaries, and hence again they will be remains in the blood only, because only small molecules they will be absorbed by this Bowman capsule. So big molecules and all, they will stay remains with the blood only. Do you understand all of you? Please tell me.
Sir.
Now, here if we'll observe, now the small molecules, everything has been collected by the Bowman capsule. So immediately Bowman capsule has been connected to what, Rob? Bowman capsule is connected to what? Bowman capsule is connected to what?
Tubule.
What you have to remember. So, the functioning of tubule which has been connected, you can observe here, the functioning of tubule which is present, tubule of nephron, is allowed to understanding reabsorption of the useful substances like glucose, amino acids, salts and water into the blood capillaries which are present surrounding by it. You may observe here. Here it is present, the blood capillary which is passing from the another side of the glomerulus. Observe all of you. So once the small molecules like glucose, amino acids and salts and like urea and water passes through this glomerulus and collecting as a filtrate by whom? Filtrate by who? Bowman capsule.
Bowman capsule.
But large molecules like proteins, still they cannot pass through this blood cells, so they will be present inside this blood. Do you understand? Yes. So protein cells, they cannot pass out through the glomerulus capillaries, they will behind in the blood. So now here if you observe, once these small molecules has been connected by the Bowman capsule, so this Bowman capsule is present immediately connected to the and a small kind of tube. What is this tube called as?
Tubule.
Now here you observe, what is the functioning of this tubule means? Very, very important, the functioning of tubule. So you may understand what is the functioning of Bowman capsule. Bowman capsule will collect the all the small substances, small molecules like glucose, amino acids, and urea, salts, etc., etc. Now, if you observe, what is the functioning of tubule? That is what my question. What is the functioning of tubule? You may notice that one end is connected to the Bowman capsule, and another end is connected to the what? Another end is connected to the Bowman tubule, right?
Urine collecting duct.
Collecting duct.
One side Bowman capsule and another side urine collecting duct. What is the function of this tubule? Means the sense of. So when the functioning of tubule of out through this glomerulus capillaries. So here whatever it is there means. So it will allows the selective absorption of useful substances. Actually, this tubule is having again some kind of porous medium. You may observe here, I will draw it. So this again, this tubule is also having some kind of porous medium. So what it will do means, so whatever the small substances which has been absorbed, so these substances again reabsorption of the useful substances like glucose, amino acids and salts, and as well as sufficient amount of water into the blood capillaries. Do you understand, all of you? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
The things are collected in this Bowman capsule, they will pass us through this tubule, and this tubule again allow to reabsorb the useful substances for our body like glucose, etc., etc. Understand, all of you? By this blood capillaries. What we should call this one? Blood capillaries. Understand, all of you? Please tell me. Not understand? Once again, can I repeat it? If you say, I will say. If not, I will go. Now observe very carefully. I will erase this and I will say you. So now, as you know that all the molecules like urea, water, glucose, amino acids, everything has been collected by whom? Collected by whom? From glomerulus. Who is collecting? Who is collecting, Ra? Are from collecting all the kinds of small molecules like urea, water, and the glucose.
Bowman capsule.
Correct. So now immediately observe, Bowman capsules one end is connected to what? Bowman capsule one end is connected to what? It is connected to the tubule, correct or not? So once these substances, whatever collected by Bowman capsule, is being passed through this tubule only. Will you accept that? Please tell me at least. Respond me, yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
The substances which is collected by the Bowman capsule, once this, they will pass through this tubule. You may notice it. Directly it is connected to water. Urine collecting. So you may observe in that so many substances are useful to us, like glucose and some salt and some amount of water. Everything is, understanding, is useful to our body. So directly I cannot dump it into the urine collectory duct, because our body needs that some amount. Only some unnecessary substances only don't want. So whenever this, all the substances are passing through this tubule, so here these tubules are surrounding by water. These tubules are surrounding by what? Blood capillary. Have you noticed it? Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
So this tubule is connected by blood capillary. So whenever the blood is coming from this another side of glomerulus, and it is surrounding by this tubule. So here the tubule again allows this blood to absorb the useful substances like glucose, and some amount of water, whatever it is required, into that blood capillaries. Do you understand? Yes. This tubule only allows to absorb, reabsorption. Understand all of you? Reabsorption. Why can't you say absorption? Means already we are using absorption here. From the glomerulus to Bowman capsule is absorbed.
Bowman capsule.
That is why I am using here reabsorption. So this reabsorption of substances, like useful substances for our body, is has been done by what? Done by tubule to the what?
Tubule.
Capillaries. Understand all of you?
Yes, sir.
So which is surrounding by it. Now, unnecessary substances like waste materials like urea and excess water and excess substances, excess amount of salts,
yes,
and all, they will remain in this tubule only. They will remain tubule. They cannot be absorbed by the blood capillaries which is surrounding by them. So that remain wastage which is stored inside that tubule will be passing to where? Will be passing to the
urine collecting duct,
which is called as what? A yellowish liquid, which is known as
urine.
Understand all of you? Please tell me. Structure of a kidney. I hope you understand very well. If anybody is having any doubt, please kindly tell me. This is what the internal structure of kidney. Now, if you'll understand this, then you can see urine collecting duct is connected to the some kind of understanding storage tank. What is the storage tank? It will be the tube. The tube will bring down. What is that tube called as?
Ureter.
Kidney tube. You forgot by the time.
Ureter.
Ureters only. Understand?
Ureter.
So ureters are connected to what? Ureters are connected to
urinary bladder.
So urinary bladder is connected to the urethra. And urethra will send out the urine outside. You can see like this downwards. It has been cut there. It is the internal structure. So now, once again, just within 2 minutes, we'll recall what is the internal structure of kidney. Can you start? Anybody? You speak. I will be silent. One by one. What is the point you have to remember in internal structure of kidney? Please. Start, yaar. Now? Okay. So as we know that every kidney is made up of what? Millions of large excretory units called as nephrons. So nephrons are excretory units. So every nephron containing two parts. What are that? That is, at least you answer that.
Cup-shaped Bowman's capsule and tube-shaped
tubule.
Upper end and lower end, a tube-like structure called as
tubule.
Now, if you'll observe this tubule, one end is connected to what? Others, are you silent? Are you the dumb fellows? One end is connected to what?
Bowman's capsule. Another end is connected to urine collecting.
And another end is connected to the urine collecting.
Urinary duct.
All of you. Next, this Bowman capsule inside, it is having a bundle of blood capillaries, which we used to call as what?
Glomerulus.
Glomeruli. Form glomeruli. Of glomeruli. Understand? So now, what is the, you may observe here, this glomeruli also having two ends. One end is connected to what? One end is connected to what?
Renal artery.
Renal artery, which will carry
renal
dirty blood.
Dirty blood.
Understanding. So contains all unnecessary substances. So that all will pass through the glomerulus. Yes or no? Now this glomerulus, what it will do? It will send
all the blood, sir.
Small molecules like glucose, amino acids, urea, water, etc. Everything has been absorbed by what? Absorbed by
about
glomerulus.
As a what? As a filtrate. What we should say?
As a filtrate.
Now, the large protein molecules, like large protein molecules, they will remains with the blood only. They will pass through the blood capillaries, which are surrounded by what? Surrounded by
tubule.
Once the absorbed substances, the filtrate which has been absorbed by the Bowman capsule will pass us through this tubule. So again, this tubule, what it will do? It will allow the blood capillaries which are surrounding by them. Useful substances like what? Useful substances by? Like glucose,
amino acids, and
amount of water. So that is why it is as reabsorption. What we should call reabsorption. Understand? Materials like excess, understanding, water and excess amount of salts and urea remains with what?
Remains in the tubule.
Understanding? They cannot reabsorb into the blood capillaries. So they finally pass us to where? They will pass us to the urine collecting duct. So from urine collecting duct to, they have been connected to what? Akshaya, are you there in meeting? Please respond me. It has been connected to ureters. So ureters are connected to urinary bladder. Urinary bladder. Urethra. And urethras will send out, passing out the urine through that urethra only. This is what the internal structure of kidney. So anybody is having any doubt, please kindly ask me. Till here, any doubt, Ra?
No doubt,
sir.
We'll understand this, then in next class we'll study the next utmost important concept called as the only structure of this nephron. How this absorption is taking place, you may ask me the question, because this draw the structure of nephron, thousands of times they used to ask in exam, but so many will draw. Means they will ask you human excretory system, means they will draw nephron structure. They will ask nephron structure, means they will draw human excretory system. So both are same. Nephron is only involving, but particularly they will mention draw the diagram of nephron. Then we have to draw the nephron diagram. And or else they will say human excretory system or urine system. Then you have to draw the first diagram. Correct or not, all of you? And those who are very good in drawing, you can learn this also. The internal structure of kidney also, you can learn. But remember, in next class, we'll study the working of human excretory system. Means, from this glomerulus to tubule, urine collecting duct, how it has been done. What is the process behind it? Everything we'll study very clearly. So with this now, I am going to start the today's class. Thank you, all of you. Any doubt, anybody, please ask me.